Sportsnet with Jay and Dan, brought to you by Tim Hortons. It's a chilly one in the studio. Hopefully you're around the fire watching this.
You forgot your undershirt today. Forgot to layer.
I know. That minus a layer at my age could be pneumonia time.
Hopefully we don't see anything peeking out of that jacket.
Hey, the Toronto Maple Leafs, their fans are worried because they're allowing a lot of goals and they aren't scoring a lot.
Right, and the Florida Panthers were in town on Monday, Dan. And you say to yourself, hey, could this be the cure to what ails the Leafs? Yeah. Could this be the cure? Could this be just what Leafs Nation needs to gain that confidence back in their team as we get closer and closer to the postseason? John Tavares certainly thought so. First period, Toronto's already up 2-0. Tavares on the power play. 42nd of the season. 3-0 Toronto. Still in the first. 43rd of the season. Passes Eddie Olczyk for the most goals by a player in his first season with the Buds. 4-2 Leafs after one. Second period. 10th career hat trick, 44th of the season for John Tavares. He's second in the league in goals behind only Alexander Ovechkin. Garrett Sparks, you want to throw your hat? No, just that's perfect. These things don't come free, you know. Joe Bowen on the call on TSN Radio. Is that, we're going with that now? Johnny Toronto? I don't mind it. First Leaf, 45 goals in a season since Dave Andrechuk in 93-94. Dubas? Yeah, Dubas. Late stages, Jace Harlock takes a run at Tavares. Ron Hainsey, favorite of Mike Babcock for reasons like this. And favorite of John Tavares. Nazem Kadri, serving the extra two, has some words for Harlock. Hey, Johnny Toronto! How about 50? Johnny Toronto's 45 goals tied for 10th on the franchise's single-season goal list with Daryl Sittler. I love seeing Nikolai Borshevsky's name on any part of the show. Any part of the show. Anytime we can get more Borshevsky, I'm in. By the way, Johnny T also matched a career high for points in a season with 86.
As my mother always says, hate is a strong word. But I'm pretty sure that Drew Doughty hates Matthew Tkachuk. Why is that? 2 years ago, this owl made Doughty hate Tkachuk and got Tkachuk suspended for 2 games. 2 years ago, and Doughty's disdain for the Flames forward is as strong as ever. He also said he would never talk to Tkachuk away from the ice. He says no one in the NHL likes him either. Third meeting between Tkachuk and Doughty this season. Calgary down one in the first. Flames power play. Tkachuk and Doughty both in front of the net. Doughty cross-checked to Tkachuk. And gets on Johnny Gaudreau. Feeds Monahan. Jack Campbell turns it aside. Tkachuk not deterred by the cross-check. Good position. Got the screen on Campbell. Early second. Tkachuk driving to the net. And hits Campbell up high. And then Tkachuk, he may have apologized there. They didn't look to be having harsh words. Shortly after, off the faceoff win, Tkachuk out to cover Doughty, gives him a shove. 9 seconds of the frame. Tkachuk driving the net, appears to bump into Campbell, and this is where the Kings say, okay, we had enough. Matt Roy goes after him, throws him down. Trevor Lewis gets in there, the linesman trying to break it up. Tkachuk and Roy both picking up minor penalties for roughing. In the third, it continues. Keep your eye on Tkachuk. As Doughty gains the zone, Tkachuk comes to the opposite side of the ice to try hit him. Then Tkachuk with a slash, Doughty with a hard slash. The linesman immediately gets between them. Oh, and there's a shot. They're chirping at each other. Doughty picks up the only penalty on the play. Every time Doughty touched the puck, they were booing by saying, ooh. Johnny Brodzinski leading a 2-on-1 scores. 2 goals on 18 shots for LA. Kings shut out the Flames.
Jets hosting the Stars. Connor Hellebuck, 200th NHL star. So weird. First period, Tyler Seguin. Miro Heiskanen shot stop. He gets the rebound. Mark Scheifele, though, bats it away with his stick to save a goal. Second period, Blake Como centering pass. Off a stick to the point. Esa Lindell shot gets by Hellebuck. Dallas Stars are on the board first. It's 1-0 under 2 minutes later.
Jumps on the pass that came from the corner.
Ben Bishop's stretch pass to Matisse Janmark, who spots Radek Faksa, who rips it by Hellebuck. 2-0 Dallas over the peg. Winnipeg, shorthanded chance here. John Klingberg can't keep it in. Adam Lowry, favorite of Jeff O'Neill. Yeah, Bishop thought that was in, but he squeezed the pillows, as Dennis Bayak likes to say. Then, with the Stars enjoying a two-man advantage in the second, Seguin, watch this shot. Right? 30 goals. Fifth time he's reached 30 goals. 3-0 Stars. Tyler Myers, not a good clearing attempt. Heiskanen to Seguin. And I like his subdued goal celebration. Second of the night, 4-0, under 5 to play now, 4-1. Jets are on the power play. Jacob Trouba to Patty Laine, who scores his first goal in 13 games and his 30th of the season. Trims the deficit to 2, but that's as close as they would get. Well, this is a great matchup, Golden Knights Blues. Ryan Reeves, this is how he gets ready for games. He tries to fight his coaches. Makes sense. It's Ryan Reeves. He's hilarious. Opening frame. Yeah, as I said, great matchup here. Vegas with the turnover. Ryan O'Reilly, all alone in front, sends it high. Malcolm Subban catching a break. Blues did lead 1-0 through one. Vladimir Tarasenko through the crease. O'Reilly gets it back, sharp angle. Subban, beautiful save. 7-2-1 over his last 10. Great stop. Second period, tied at one. Jay Bouwmeester, what a beautiful skater. Up ice to O'Reilly and O'Reilly. Got a goal. 27 on the season. St. Louis wins 3-1. They've won 4 straight.
So if it continues that way and the Sharks lose, then Calgary has nothing to worry about. They continue to have that cushion for first in the Pacific. Dallas, some separation in the wild card with that win against the Jets. Minnesota, a very costly loss. On Tuesday, Yotes host the Hawks. You got Vancouver at home to the Ducks. Yeah, they're still alive. And LA heads to Edmonton. Yeah, Edmonton, why not?
Why not? Why not, eh? There are only 2 teams in the Eastern Conference who have clinched a playoff spot. For the Bruins and Lightning, you might ask the question my wife asks me every day.
My wife.
Why are you here? The answer, because the game is on the schedule and people have bought tickets. And these two teams have the best records in the NHL since February 1. Lightning beat the Bruins in 5 games in last year's postseason. Could they meet again in the second round this year? It would be quite a series if this game was any indication. Steven Stamkos reaches the 40-goal mark for the 5th time in his career. First time in franchise history. 3 players have each scored 90 points in a season. That'd be Stamkos, Kucherov, and Point. 1-0 Tampa. Less than 2 minutes later, David Pastrnak slides it between Andrei Vasilevsky's legs to Brad Marchand. Marchand, 22 points in his last 14 games. It's 1-1. Then with 5 to play in the period, Victor Hedman to Stamkos, another beaut, second of the game, 2-1. Tampa Bay after 1. It's now 3-2 Boston in the second. Pastrnak to Marchand. It's off Vasilevsky's leg and in. I mean, it went airborne. And then Vasilevsky knocked it in his own net. So Boston up 4-2 after 2. But in the third, Stamkos, in alone, cannot finish. Hedman tucks it home. Victor Hedman leads all defense with 17 points in his last 14 games. Lightning are now within 1. Nikita Kucherov is just otherworldly at this point. 121 points on the season, tied at 4. Final minute, Anthony Cirelli. Lightning, fourth team in NHL history with at least 59 wins in a season. They win an absolute thriller. How the Eastern Conference standings look. Look at the Pens and the Islanders, both just 1 point back of Washington for first in the Metro. Each of the three teams in the wildcard battle did not play Monday, but they're all in action Tuesday. Montreal hosts Florida, Canes in Washington, Jackets host the Isles.
It's a spring tradition born 6 years ago. Jays finishing camp with games in Montreal. The Brewers, the ones invited to La Belle Provence this time around, minus one Brewers regular, Ryan Braun, forgot his passport. So customs officials said, au revoir, Monsieur Braun.
He was in 2015.
Ooh. I took French all the way up to grade 9. That's all I have to show for it. The Jays left their entire starting rotation in Toronto. Bo Bichette made the trip. Charging play to start the... He's going to start the season in AAA. Bottom seven. Bichette singled to right. He was 1-for-2. Hit .421 this spring.
He can just hit, folks. He can flat
and he goes first to third on the Eric Sogard single. Those are interesting Brewers caps. Scored to cut the to a one-run game. Score didn't matter. Brewers won at 10-5. Bichette, oh, he got eaten up by that chopper. Turf is kind of wonky there. A lot of auto shows and things going on at the Big O, I'm sure. It's a good move. When you get older, you become an usher, you get to see all the games.
I know, we should do that. We're already at that age. All right, so it's settled. We're going to become ushers.
And you get to help people.
The only question is where? Where do we become ushers?
That's to be determined later.
Good for Ovi.
I've never seen, it's stuck in the window. I never saw...
What? We could never do that again if we tried.
Have you ever seen Gary Bettman that happy?
He did seem very happy, dude. What was with Ovi's haircut?
Yeah, he got it all shaved off.
I mean, I realize I shouldn't talk, but...
Dustin Byfuglien missed his 39th game of the season on Monday. Took part in morning skate, though. Wore a non-contact jersey. He's been out for over a month after suffering an ankle injury against Colorado on February 14th. You know what? Byfuglien turns 34 on Wednesday. And you're probably wondering, or you're thinking, man, he's missed a lot of hockey this year. He has. He's on his way to playing the fewest games of any season since he became a full-time NHLer with Chicago 12 years ago.
He leads the Jets in ice time when he plays. They need him back. That game against Dallas was a great example. Kyle Lowry celebrated his 33rd birthday Monday. With the Raptors off, Fred VanVleet was asked, did they celebrate?
No, we practice. You know, he loves practice, so we came out here, got a good practice in just for him, special gift wrap.
Wished him a happy birthday, and he was in a good mood. We watched the film, and he was in a bad mood, and then I said, what are you in a bad mood for? Jeez, come on, it's your birthday. So a little bit of a roller coaster ride with him today. No. I told him he looked 27.
Wow, he was insulted. So.
No, he said, you know. Yeah.
33.
Good laugh, Nurse.
Nurse, want to say to Coach Nurse, we'd love to have you on the television program. We know we're on late, but you seem like a late night guy.
We'll send an Uber down, grab you.
Raptors are back in action Tuesday against the Bulls. I like our NBA music.
Again, composed by Rod Black. Toronto FC introduced Alejandro Pozuelo on Monday afternoon. Spanish midfielder becomes Toronto's third designated player after transferring from Belgium. He played for Genk. Pozuelo hopes to join the lineup and play right away. TFC, they're in action Friday. They're hosting New York City FC. It's on TSN 4 and 5.
FC versus FC. You know, people are always saying, I wish there was some sort of award segment that highlighted the best and worst from the night in sports. You're in luck. because the Jannies are next on Jay and Dan.
Fourth round of the Miami Open. Jekka Andreescu taking on 21 seed Anett Kontaveit. First set, Andreescu down 4-1, facing break point. Kontaveit, the forehand, takes a 5-1 lead. Okay. Next game, Andreescu showing signs of life. She's won 10 straight matches. Finds the line on back-to-back forehands.
Oh, it's fabulous.
She had four break points in the end. Failed to convert on all of them. Still in the game. She drops the set 6-1. Between sets.
Didn't pull it off this time.
So Andreescu has work done on her right shoulder. Has had issues with that. Dates back to her title run at Indian Wells. Kontaveit broke to start the second set. Very next game, Andreescu comes up lame. He gives up on the point and the match.
I think that's
the shoulder,
it.
Too much to overcome. Andreescu's win streak comes to an end. She has to retire from the match.
Same tournament, Denis Shapovalov with his third round match against Andrei Rublev. Shapo lost their only meeting back in 2017. It was one of his 28 winners. The beautiful backhand. Shapo took the opener 6-3. Second set, Rublev serving at 5-3. Shapo, break point, Rublev shanks it. Second set needed a tie break. Shapo with double match point.
Ladies and gentlemen, please.
These tennis players need complete silence to play their sport. Shapo had another match point. Rublev sends it long as Shapo makes a second straight round of 16 at a 1,000 event in straight sets.
The Jannies. David Pastrnak. Puck at the side of the net. Sends the pass through Andre Vasilevskiy's legs right to Brad Marchand, who scores. What a game this was. Pastrnak thought he was going to hit him in the head.
Spring training. Yankees, Nats, Giancarlo Stanton up the middle. Trey Turner, nice play. Baseball's back soon. For a big time 6-3. We got the Sunday Nighters on TSN, don't we, Producer Tim?
Huge.
Stars and Jets. Connor Hellebuck. Oh, yeah. Flash in the... Those Jets jerseys have really grown on me.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I'm cool with them. Everyone in Utah is cool with Jimmer Fredette, played at BYU. They gave him a standing O. He didn't do well. 1-for-10 from the field. Still, the name Jimmer, pretty awesome.
And from the Big O in Montreal, Bo Bichette. Nice play.
Go ahead, Bo.
What a spring he had. Again, he's going to start the season in AAA.
You know, we talked about being a well-rounded.
Why do we show you the plays of the week at the beginning of the week instead of the end? As my wife likes to say,
my wife.
I could explain it to you, but you still wouldn't understand. Usually, she's talking about where babies come from. Just recorded a brand new Jay and Dan podcast talking all about our very first live podcast this past Friday in Ottawa. More to come? Oh, stay tuned, people. You can catch it on the iHeartRadio app.
Worst play of the day. Shades of Dan Cloutier.
And they got the job done, like Bryce said.
From center ice, they score a bouncing puck.
Except this was Corey Schneider.
I wish more goalies would go with the full helmet cage again. Well,
I was at that game when Cloutier allowed that one from center against the wing.
It would just be safer. Everyone's talking about how the masks aren't built for how hard the shots are these days. Go back to the masks and helmets. Jonathan Isaac, highlight of the night.
Boy, he took to block that one, didn't he? He took it so far back, I thought Butler was going to be able to block it.
All right.
You blew it. We point out our errors. You nailed it, this says, because you threw your note card and got it stuck in the wall.
I did. That was so weird.
The second one I'm not even referencing because I don't see it.
Here. There we go.
I don't see anything going wrong. Someone said I got a pronunciation wrong on a name, but I disagree. So let's agree to disagree. In the Jazz pack, I said Booker had a career-high 70-point game last year. It was 2 years ago.
Mm, big mistake there. So much for our Gemini.
They don't have those anymore.
Oh, well. They're bound to go away someday.
They're called Screenies now.
Oh, they still have them, but they're a different name.
Is it the same trophy? No.
I don't know. I'm not sure.
And we'll never know.
When did the nominations come out?
Oh, they came out a while ago.
Oh, they did?
Guess we weren't part of those.
Did they submit our applications?
Au revoir, Monsieur Braun.